really hard to get. My first thought, which to me felt inarguable, was that political polarization was positive because it is a free country. Okay, that's okay. That's something people used to say a lot. I don't know, you were really young, but people used to say that all the time, and they don't say it anymore, perhaps because our country has gotten less free. Maybe even more Soviet. It's worth noting that much of the progress and prosperity of the last century was owed to the Cold War, during which the U.S. was very polarized and had an ideological foe against communism and the Soviet Union, which sought to spread their godless ideology. The Soviet Union was not a free country. Free countries must allow for dissident thoughts and opinions. And are at least on paper, maybe even on a piece of paper called the Constitution. Though I wouldn't know because I haven't read it. Discourse should be in service of truth. history, and like history, the driving force of which has always been conflict. Anyway, so that was my kind of big idea, which a lot of German men in the 19th century were ripping on. Last year it was tolerable, but in the last few months it's become more and more congested. Another thing I don't like, not only about the goal, but broadly about life trips at the crosswalk, are the new restrictions. In the group, we had a great degree of freedom about where to go, where to stay, and whether to participate in the war. If a day was sunny, we might ride horses with our brothers, eat what we can, train and laugh, and feel blessed. However, these days, you have to go to the office before 8 a.m. and stay there till 4 p.m. If you don't go, you're considered absent, and the wage for that day is cut from your salary. We're now used to that, but it was especially difficult in the first 2 or 3 months. There's another thing I dislike, and that's how restricted our lives are now, unlike anything we've experienced before. The Taliban used to be free of restrictions, but now we sit in one place, behind a desk and a computer, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Life's become so wearisome. You do the same things every day. Being away from the family is only double the problem, because they can't afford to bring their families to Kabul, because they don't make enough money. So I don't like the Taliban. We have a lot of religious differences, and none of those guys would follow me back on Twitter. But it's interesting, right, for this Taliban guy to think about his prior life in conflict and strife was so much more satisfying than this so-called civilized drudgery that we have crafted for ourselves in the West. It's almost as if the point of life is to struggle. You guys are missing a lot. That in resolution and complacency, consensus and comfort, life can become contemptible. This condition is a nihilistic one. What Nietzsche called the last man, Fukuyama, the end of history, etc. Means anything, but rather that in the neutered, depolarized discourse, where nebulously defined misinformation threatens our so-called democracy, the only views that are permissible are those that are so benign, as we see in the perverted efforts of the OpenAI, so harmless that they are without any consequence at all.